Indian media's rhetoric revolves around hurling baseless accusations on Pakistan. Crafted to gain sympathies in order to hide their own wrongdoings, the cheap rating stunts seem failing to impress anyone. More in this report by Seemab, Abbasi.
Keeping in mind viewers' good taste, one can hardly believe that there will be any serious following of the directionless Indian media, which sells nothing but sensationalism for cheap ratings. Happy are those who just turn to something sane. The question arises how the chemistry of these directionless minds was formed. When Muslims demanded a separate country, sensing that the narrow-mindedness of the Hindu leadership won't let anything good to happen for them, Hindus confronted the claim, stating that the facts were altogether different. Let us not go to the arguments, as their own extremist mindset did not spare their very own father of the so-called secular state. Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi was murdered on account of observing fast till death. For whom? Yes, to demand India to give due share of assets to Pakistan. Murder of Indira Gandhi is yet another justification of the fact that the minorities were pushed to a point of no return. They retaliated and did what they could do to get themselves heard. Murder of Rajiv Gandhi, yet another testimony of Indian nose-poking in affairs of the others instead of keeping their own house in order. Away from the politics, India is believed to have been most notorious when it comes to showing sportsmanship in the field of sports. Who could have forgotten the torching of Kolkata Stadium in 1996 semi-final of the World Cup? Pakistan faced the same hostility in 1999 at the same ground where the authorities had to vacate the jam-packed stadium to complete the test match. A state ranked sky-high in rape crimes should also spend some time to comfort its own fellows instead of threatening others to cut their petty exports. Seemab Abbasi, PTV World News, Islamabad.
Which is Indian.